I grew up in Zephyr Hills, Florida. It's a small town, so everybody does know everybody. I've lived there my entire life. I did very well in high school. I graduated with honors. I took a lot of AP and honors classes. When I was younger, a family friend of ours gave me a Florida State cheerleading uniform and came with pom-poms.
She was the best child any father could have. She was fabulous. Never any problems, always had a great smile, just a joy to be around. And she kept saying she was going to FSU, going to FSU. And then when she first got there, I knew she made the right choice.
My first semester was really, it was a lot of science classes. I was in six classes. I wanted to go to med school. I didn't go out a lot just because I was in a lot of classes. So it was the week before finals and we drove to Potbelly's and we were just hanging out. This guy started following me around and I like said to him, I was like, what, like stop, you know, stop following us. And a man standing at the bar saw that like I was uncomfortable with this guy following me. And so he kind of like grabbed me and like was like, this is my girlfriend, leave her alone. And I was like, thank you. Like the guy left and I was just like, thank you. And he's like, do you want to take a shot? And I said, sure. So I turned around like to make sure that this guy was gone. And when I turned back around, he handed me a shot. I'm fairly certain that there was something in that drink. As a college student, I had been drunk before and I had not drank nearly enough to become drunk and incompetent that night. I remember being in a cab, and there were three guys in the cab also. Anyone you ask would tell you, I never would go home with a guy, period. And especially not three people that I didn't know. I remember specific things after that. I was in like an apartment, and this guy was sexually assaulting me. He was raping me. He was on top of me and I couldn't really breathe that much, but I was saying, please stop, stop. Like, I remember his roommate or whoever this other guy was came in and he was saying, like, dude, stop. Like, what are you doing? She's telling you to stop. Since his door to the bedroom, like, wouldn't lock, he picked me up and he carried me into the bathroom. He said, the door will lock in here. He put me on the tile bathroom floor. I was trying to like push him off and kick him off, but he was just too big. And I said, please stop multiple times. And I said, no. Eventually he pushed his hand over my face and like pushed my face into the floor. And he just continued to rape me. He finished and then he put my clothes back on and he said, you can leave now. And then he's like, I'll take you home on my scooter. I mean, okay, I had no idea where I was. I didn't know how else I was supposed to get home. I wanted to get out of there. This was the worst feeling because I didn't want to hold on to him, you know? But I was afraid that I was gonna fall off of the scooter. He dropped me off at the intersection where I told him because I didn't want him to know where I lived. I didn't know really what I was supposed to do. I tweeted, someone help me. My friend responded and she was like, well, tell me what happened. And we decided that we need to call the police.
You said she was raped?
Yeah.
Okay, so she did not know the person?
No.
The Florida State University police took me in the back of a police car to the hospital. I got all of the blood work and the rape kit and everything. They were watching bruises appear as I was laying in the hospital bed.
We got a call about 3 a.m. We grabbed some stuff and we jumped in the car and started heading to FSU as quick as we could. She was laying in the hospital bed and we each went to one side and we just held her and all three of us laid there, sat there and cried.
That's when Investigator Angulo came in. I told him kind of everything.
I'm very pro-law enforcement, and Tallahassee PD was there, and we assumed they were taking care of things.
Went back in the beginning of January. It was my first class on Tuesday, and I see him walk into the class, and I knew, I was like, that's him. They were about to take attendance, and that's what I needed to stay calm and just kind of wait it out. He was one of the very last names that they called, and my teacher said Jameis Winston, and he raised his hand. I didn't know who he was.
The nation's number one high school quarterback, Jameis Winston, won Gatorade State Player of the Year this past season.
Jameis, tell me why you chose Florida State.
Just because we're trying to build a tradition there, and hopefully we can get a few national championships and hopefully a Heisman Trophy.
I notified Investigator Angulo of who it was. I think at that point he knew that he was going to be the big football star. He said, this is a huge football town. You really should think long and hard about whether you want to press charges or not. It didn't make sense to me, really. I just thought, like, you know, that's his job. Why is he not gonna do it?
Winston is as much as I've ever seen for a first-year starting quarterback.
Winston into the end zone, touchdown Florida State.
Sports teams are the business on these campuses. When you build stadiums that cost $200-300 million, when you build athletic facilities that can get up into that range as well, and then you look at multi-billion-dollar television contracts, when you're talking about that kind of money, there's an enormous investment in a student athlete who may be a quarterback on a top 20 team that's pulling in hundreds of millions of dollars in revenue.
19-year-old Winston is on the verge of leading his team to the ultimate victory.
Our main goal is to win a national championship.
He's had a meteoric rise to fame, becoming the starting quarterback as a freshman.
He's a star on the team. And that doesn't mean he's guilty, but the point is, you have to treat that person like you would anyone else in these cases, and that didn't happen here.
Poised to play in and possibly win the national championship, a front runner for the Heisman Trophy Award, Florida State quarterback Jameis Winston now possibly finds himself in some hot water. Winston is part of an ongoing investigation into a sexual assault complaint filed nearly a year ago, but today was turned over to the state attorney.
As soon as I saw this story break, I thought how terribly, terribly unfair it is to this young man.
And I think it's very, very unfortunate that this young dude with this Magic Johnson caliber smile,
yep,
and the level of production and the things that he has done en route to pursuing a national championship and a Heisman Trophy, and now it comes out? It just stinks to me.
DNA analysis confirmed the DNA provided by Winston matched that sample taken from the accuser.
Although he has never spoken directly to cops or prosecutors, Jameis Winston, through his attorneys, maintains his innocence and says any sex was consensual.
Jameis Winston, he's into the promised land. Touchdown FSU.
His voice, his way, his team.
Our football team kept winning games. We were gonna play in the national championship. All these people were praising him. People were just calling me names, a slut, a whore. I got a tweet from a girl who I didn't know. The tweet was like, why would you blame such a good guy for doing this? People were threatening me, my family, and there was other people that were threatening my sorority, saying we're gonna burn down their house.
Jameis Winston will not be charged with a rape that allegedly happened exactly a year ago. Here's prosecutor and FSU alumni, Willie Meigs.
We've carefully examined all the evidence in this case and have concluded that no charges will be filed against anyone in this case.
And we found no evidence of any drugs of any sort in her blood system.
Jameis Winston raped that girl?
I think I did not have sufficient evidence to prove that he sexually assaulted her against her will. I think things that happened there that night were not good.
As FSU fights for the national title, the alleged victim drops out of school. FSU football fans are predictably delighted by this result.
Jameis Winston.
He's amazing. What a great guy.
Jameis Christ.
The justice system was proved right. Right? It worked.
Every school in the country that's a big time powerhouse football team has players dealing with that shit.
Some girl got jealous, wanted to be like a part of the scene, you know. She was a liar.
Football star Jameis Winston, Florida State quarterback, had the game of his young life Monday when he led the Seminoles to the national championship.
Sexual assault cases are always tough. Probably the first time someone is apprehended is not the first time that they have engaged in forceful conduct on someone.
I went to see my victim's advocate, and in that meeting, we were just talking. She was like, we just want to let you know, like, there's another victim from him.
It's my pleasure to announce the 2013 Heisman Memorial Trophy winner, Jameis Winston, Florida State University.
Is it hard for you to believe that this has all happened?
I kind of just want to know, like, why me? Doesn't really make sense.